Welcome to Inside the Vibe TV. I'm your host, Yvonka Young, and I am here to bring you the pre-launch band party for Carnival 2014. And we are ready to party carnival style. As you can see behind me, the bands are getting ready. We've got costumes. We've got various bands formulating here. It is going to be a fun time come October 12th. And we're looking forward to you joining us right here at the Florida Fairgrounds for Carnival 2014. Mr. Rafiq Muhammad, the executive director for the Miami Broward Carnival. Mr. Muhammad, hello.
Hi, how are you?
It's great to be here tonight.
Oh, it's great to be talking to you too.
Oh, thank you. Listen, I know that there have been some great things that are happening. We're getting ready, preparing tonight with a launch party for Carnival 2014, October 12th. And I was wondering if you could just give us an idea of some of the new things that we can expect this year.
Well, obviously we have a new venue. It's at the Fairgrounds. We had to move from the stadium this year because they have a game that conflicted. So we found this new venue, and it's going to be wonderful because it's bigger, it's better, we have more bands. It's going to be a little bit of street parade, a little bit of parade inside the stadium, lots more vendors, 20 bands, wonderful costumes, creative costumes, everything you want, cuisine from all over the Caribbean.
Wow. Now, where are most of the bands coming from?
Oh, they're all local. Okay. They're all local. Broward County, Miami County. We do have some bands from out of town, but not much. New York have their own bands, and they have Carnival. Toronto have their own bands, they have Carnival. So every band that here is local. Some of them partner with some of the bands up in New York and Toronto. But we can all say that everybody is homegrown.
Excellent. So tonight we're here getting ready for Carnival 2014, and I want to know, what can we expect this evening?
You're going to expect to see some wonderful costume. 20 bands will have their models and parade. Wonderful, creative, beautiful models, just there having a good time. And when you, actually, I don't know if there's some way to get people to come down here tonight by this interview, but they should be here. Mm-hmm. There's no place else to be but here tonight.
All right, and just one last thing, and I'm going to let you go. I know you're busy tonight. Yeah, yeah. But tell us, what is the value of this event to South Florida?
Wow, this is a $60 million economic impact on the economy of South Florida. There's money spent. For Carnival, you can't get a hotel room. You can't get a rental car. I mean, people come from all over the world to Miami Broward Carnival.
Excellent. And cultural-wise, tell me the value of that. I know there is a huge Caribbean population in South Florida, and I was just wondering if you would speak to that and how Carnival plays a role in cultural awareness, for one, and cultural celebration.
Well, one of the good things about Carnival is that people think it's a party, but it's not a party. You hit the nail on the head. It's all about culture. It's about carrying on the heritage that was left behind. I mean, steel band is the only instrument that was invented in the 21st century. There's no other instrument that was invented. That was invented in the Caribbean, Trinidad to be exact. So that is wonderful. So it's not only the costume that you see, it's the music. Mm-hmm. It's the culture, it's the wire bending, it's the feathers. I mean, everything that you could think about is involved in Carnival.
Excellent. Mr. Muhammad, thank you so much for your time. We'll see you inside.
Thank you for
having
me.
And come back and join us. Thank you. All right, and you're back with Inside the Vibe TV. I am standing here with Ms. Joan Hinkson. She is the chairperson for Carnival 2014. And Joan, you want to tell us a little bit about what's happening here tonight, sort of what your role is, and just encourage people to come out in October.
Okay, tonight we are launching the 2014 Miami Broward Carnival. This is 30 years of celebration. Tonight, all of the bands, all the masqueraders are out to just portray their theme for October 12th, 2014. This is the venue. We're actually promoting the venue for Carnival. This venue is a fantastic venue. It's all inclusive. We have a street parade right into the park on October 12th. We have 22 registered bands. We have 5 steel bands. We have 11 junior bands. So we know we're encouraging everybody to come out. If you're watching this evening, come out and support the bands. Join a band, and you're going to have a plenty fun.
Good.
October 12, 2014.
Thank you.
Yes,
thank you.
Welcome.
Thanks for stopping and talking to us today. I am here with Rolando and Rodney of the Trick or Treat One Island Band. Gentlemen, tell me what we can expect when your band hits the stage tonight.
Well, for tonight's presentation, obviously we're going to give everybody a little bit of a taste of what the One Island Band Big and Strong presentation is really going to be for 2014. If anybody saw our presentation last year, we really stepped it up a notch in terms of what we bring to the table, in terms of bringing a band for Miami Carnival. And we plan on taking that and kicking it up even that much more in terms of taking it to the next level this year.
That's excellent. Listen, how many years have you been doing this, and how long has your band been together?
12 years. 12 years in the making and going strong.
Excellent. Benita, tell me a little bit about your band. Is this your first year participating? And sort of what your theme is this year?
Major Players has been around for 20 years, bringing mass in Miami. Our theme this year is epic. It's a journey. I play queen of the band, and our different sections represents all our different parts of the band. Our band owner is Allison Lemire, and the band leader is Omar Boddington.
Right. You got some lovely headdresses back here. Can you tell me about some of them?
Okay, our designer is Mr. Clifford Smith, and this section is called Ebony. Then we have Fusion coming through, and we have Pride, and we have Theme. It all represents a journey of epic for Major Players this year.
Samantha Lee designs the costumes for Major Players, and she's going to give us an idea of what goes into designing a costume for Carnival.
Okay, first of all, you have to get a team, and then you go with the flow with the team. You speak with the band leader, of course, and then we sit down and we decide to, in my case, I think sexy. Okay, and I think of how the costume will flow in a woman and a guy. Because you don't have to be very, very skinny to look sexy. You can look sexy in anything. So I have this particular one for the very, very sexy, who wants to be very, very, daring. And I have the skirt option, who doesn't want to be too daring like myself.
Okay.
The guy costume, well, too bad. We only have daring. And daring means we just want you to come out here and have a good time. And like I said, what goes into designing is that atmosphere, and also includes the theme. You have to have an idea, of course, and you go with the flow. You know, you just go with that flow. You get that notch, you go with the flow.
Okay. Thank you.